Hi, I'm Rich from Trapping ETV, and welcome to my fur shed. Earlier this year on various social media and that, I shared a new snaring system that had been sent to me. This is Lights Out Snaring, their Coyote snares, okay? This is not only going to be a first look at it, it's going to be a review. I've got a season under my belt now using these, and I'll show you what I like, what I don't like, what I think of them. All right, the first thing you're gonna notice is that that's the entire snare, okay? That is the entire snare. And look at the size of that spring. This is the largest spring that was ever made. And you can see that it's not as near along of arms for leverage, not near as thick of steel in the wire. Now, there's a couple of things that's important for. The longer this is, the more leverage you have. And the whole idea is to put leverage on that coyote against that lock. This produces 75 pounds of pressure and 4 inches. It opens up to a 4-inch spread. So that's a big spread once it gets crowded down enough to fire. The other thing you're gonna notice on it is the trigger is actually on the spring, okay? And being on the spring means that you don't have any vagaries of it riding around on the cable. The other system has its trigger on the cable, and of course you get any flex or bend or whatever. That's why we have problems with this not firing when we have entanglement. Now, that problem has been taken care of here because you've just got the actual push against it. It's not riding on a cable. The cable can't slide out or back or anything else. It's all taken care of. What I like, very first thing, I'm going to talk about some of the other features, but the very first thing I like is that he is the first one, Corey from Lights Out Snaring, to put it all together, okay? And when I say that, I mean not only the kill spring and the nice cable and all that, but he made it into a system. You're very familiar with how much I like the power ram. And the reason for that is the power ram, if you've got a foot on it and you have... You pre-rigged your snare with a piece of wire, so it was just a matter of, you don't even have to hardly slow down to set that. You set it down beside the trail, you put your snare on, you take and release the safety and you toggle off, your extension around a tree. That's it. You can just about do it at a walk. And it is so easy, there's no doing it wrong. So many times, when we have gone to free-hanging snares, you know, there's the whammy to deal with, the nine wire, there's the, it's either a plastic whammy or a steel whammy, a screw-on whammy, but it also set the length of the size of your snare. And you're trying to do all of this while you're behind a tree, reaching out, you know, across the trail, because you don't want to walk on the trail. I don't walk on trails anyway. And it's frustrating. And then when you add in a kill spring, it's more weight. And it has that effect of wanting to fall down. And then you got to reach over there and you got to pull it up. You got to take your gloves off because you've got a breakaway in here, an S-hook breakaway. Well, that means that this snare can actually fall through itself and disappear. So then you got to take your gloves off and feed it back through. You can hear the frustration in my voice. What he's done, though, is he's made it all into a system. So we've got our snare. And you'll notice that there's two washers right here. And he's made these out of nine wire. So this is not something cheap. It's not light and flimsy. It's nine wire and it's got like this corkscrew on the end. How you put them together is just like this. It is so simple. And then just take and twist her all together. Now, I can tell you from the number of coyotes I've caught, you don't have to worry about it on twisting. No worries at all. So now, it's becoming a system. We have a pre-made size already. We can't move our support in any way that affects how it hangs. It hangs sweet every time. He's got this giant spring here, but he has taken and put a kink in his cable here so that it hangs there. And look how it stays, right? High quality components. This is a Sullivan 280 breakaway, S-hook breakaway. I'll talk 1 second here about this cable. You'll notice that it's black. It's anodized, which is kind of cool because what it does right away is it means that we don't have to boil it. It's anodized, which is an oxidation. It's put on electronically. So there's no oil on there. So away you go. Whether you like black or not, I don't think color matters. I do think smell matters. So it's anodized, and I just put them on there, go hang them out there. Works like a hot damn for me. I don't worry a lot about the smell of steel when it comes to coyotes, especially in the farmland, because they crawl under how many barbed wire every day. Now, you've got your spring here hanging here. This is a little bit of a step away from what's normal, is the particular type of lock he chose. Now he chose, let's grab one over here. He chose the Kiefer, okay, because it allowed him to use his system to make all these components into a system. But one of the biggest problems that we have with kill springs or with the cam locks is our heavily haired coyotes will take and that either get hair on the cam lock or you'll get hair jammed in the cam lock and it won't stay locked up tight. Well, this has the ability as it slides down to push hair out of the way. And when it gets to the end, it does something else that's pretty neat too. I'm gonna show you that in a minute. The system is so easy, okay? The fact that I can do it from standing behind that tree and not get anywhere near the trail is perfect. Works so well for me. That big spring is there for killing, and yet it hangs out of the way. It's not a problem. You've got the breakaway for deer, moose, and elk, which is important for me because I catch lots of those every year. It's just a nice system. I have no concerns whatsoever with the 9-wire going around the tree. Just take and bring it around the tree and give it a loose wrap and then put that tail, usually you're gonna have a tail, down just so it braces it in place. What happens then is that whole 9-wire and everything can swivel around the tree if you want. I can never see them breaking this, I can't. This is 1/16 1x19 cable. I cannot see the 9-wire ever getting broke. I'm gonna use them on wolves as a matter of fact. Okay, so how do they work? Here we go. This is really cool. This is really cool. Now what we've got here is an actual used snare, okay? And you can see this, that is, we are at 2 1/8 inches by 2.5 inches. That's how far that snare got pulled down. As the Kiefer gets pulled down, you'll notice that it takes and it bends the cable. It kinks the cable so that this spot here actually now has become its own stop, okay? It can't slide beyond it. So now it is kinked solid. At this point, the spring hasn't fired yet, okay? This is kinked solid. When it pulls hard enough, and you can see here, I've got this all set together just the way it would be if the snare was on there. You can see that this is actually the total length of, I cut this off right at the end of this. So there's the total length that spring, that 75 pounds where the spring was in after it fired. And it then pushes back against this, which is already locked in place because of that kink in the cable. It is lethal. It is lethal. And that's how big the snare was around the coyote's neck. I mean, that is so tight. It's unbelievable. Flawless. They have worked so well for me. The only complaint I have, I know everybody's rolling their head, trappers are never happy, is that this gets in so tight, you have to be careful when you're pulling your hides, okay? Especially if you get some that are right up against the back of the skull nut, you might need to give a nick or two with a knife just to get it to separate there, because when that snare pulls down, it is tight, and it does leave a distinct mark on the hide. I haven't tore anything or haven't damaged anything, but as I've pulled it apart, it's like I look at it and I just make sure. Okay? So my first look and my review is they have worked really well for me. I've had gone away from free hanging snares because of the pain that I was talking about with trying to get the length of the snare set and the whammy in place and get it rammed on the end of the nine wire or whatever. It was just such a big pain in the butt, and you had all these components that you had to gather up. I take a handful of the nine wires and, you know, a dozen snares in my pocket, and I can walk through around a bait and back to my machine in 15 minutes, and I have them all set. It is so quick because I am back there behind that tree. I can hang it right over top of, here's my trail. I can hang it right over the trail. I can get it the right height that I want ever before I ever start twisting this on or adjusting anything, right? It's right there. It is just so simple. I'm extremely happy with the system, and it has worked really well. I don't know. If lethal snares are legal where you are, check them out, give them a try.